Hello and welcome to the session of electromagnetic band gap structures. In this lecture, we will see a small introduction to the electromagnetic structures. What are they and its features and the different types of EBG structures. A few applications are also discussed in this lecture. What is an EBG? Electromagnetic band gap structure, shortly called as EBG or PBG, that is photonic band gap structures, or artificial periodic objects, so that can prevent or assist the propagation of electromagnetic waves in a specified band of frequencies. So they can assist or prevent for all incident angles and for all polarization states. So these was first developed by Ely in the University of California in 1993. So they have devised an experimental setup and proved that no waves can pass through this structure in the microwave frequency range, in a specified microwave frequency range. So though it is a photonic band gap structure, the first experimental structure was done in the microwave frequency range only. In a similar fashion, so by the same time, photonic crystal concept was discovered in the optical frequency region. There are about two basic types of electromagnetic band gap structures. So either we can use these periodic structures in the substrate as holes digged in the structure, so that is called as perforated structures, or periodic metallic patches can be fabricated over a substrate material. The first one, that is the perforated structure, so this is slightly difficult to achieve, and the second one, that is metallo-dielectric structures, where this can be fabricated using printed circuit technology, and hence, so it is widely used in many of the applications like antennas or for signal integrity applications. And the first structure which was developed by Ely was a perforated structure, three-dimensional perforated structure. There are various other configurations or structures we can have with the EBG structures. Either it may be an one-dimensional structure or a two-dimensional structure or a three-dimensional structure. The basic one-dimensional structure is the EBG transmission line, a line over which a substrate and periodic patches or holes are in the substrate material. So that is the basic one-dimensional structure. In two-dimensional structures, so we'll be having a ground plane, over that substrate material will be there, and above that some metallic patches of different shapes can be fabricated over that. So this forms a two-dimensional structure. So three-dimensional structure, so it is a combination of wood, so this is a wood pile EBG or tripod EBG, so all these things comes under a three-dimensional EBG structures. So these are the complete EBG structures. They can assist or stop the frequencies in all polarization angles and in for all incident angles. So the basic one or a widely used EBG structure is the mushroom EBG structure. So this was first proposed by Daniel F. Sivenpiper in the year 1999. So this was first given as a high impedance structure, and there are no possibility of the surface waves to propagate through that. So since the geometry is similar to a mushroom structure, so this is known as mushroom EBG. So this consists of a metallic ground plane, over that there will be a dielectric substrate material, and above the substrate material periodic metallic patches will be fabricated, and there will be vias connecting the metallic patches, top metallic patches, with the ground plane. And so the side view shows the clear picture as the similar to a structure of a mushroom. So this in the right side, so it is a honeycomb like structure. So instead of square metal patches, so the top metal patch can be of any shape. Since this has vias, it resembles the shape of a mushroom. So the equivalent circuit for this EBG is LC equivalent 1. So simple LC equivalent. So this is a rough estimation of any design, and this can be represented, the simple mushroom structure can be represented as an L. The vias connecting the top and the bottom patches represents L, and the gap between the adjacent patches it gives the capacitance value. So Z is the impedance for the structure, and the bandwidth of the stop band is given by 1 by eta naught into root of L by C, and this can stop frequencies in this particular band bandwidth. And the next one is the UCPBG, normally called as uniplanar compact PBG, simply the UCPBG. So this was also developed in the same period by Ito in the University of California, and this has the advantage that it has no vias. So this is a complete planar structure, and the extension portions, so this gives the inductance, and these gaps, they provide the capacitance. So this is also can be represented by a simple LC equivalent circuit, and this is widely used as frequency selective surfaces in the microwave and millimeter wave regions. There are two main characteristics or features of EBG structures. So one is the surface wave suppression, the other one is the in-phase reflection coefficient. Surface wave suppression represents that, so this EBG structure has the ability to suppress the surface waves at certain frequency regions. So that has the name electromagnetic band gap. So there will be a specific band gap in the frequency spectrum where no waves can propagate. So when you measure the dispersion diagram, when you characterize an EBG, and when you get the diagram, dispersion diagram for a particular EBG structure, we can see that there is a definite band gap, or there is a frequency range where no waves can propagate. And the second basic feature is the in-phase reflection coefficient. So here the frequency, the in-phase means, so 0 degree reflection phase. So at the frequency of operation, so they can have a reflection phase of 0 degrees. Usually any metallic element will have a reflection phase of 180 degrees. So in order to have the bottom or the ground plane, we should have a definite distance from the metallic or the patch. But if it is a perfect magnetic conductor, or if the reflection phase is 0 degrees, we can place the ground plane very near to the antenna element or the top patch. So that makes the structure very, very compact. So that is the major advantage of using this structure. So by having these principles, by suppressing the surface waves, so we can have no mutual coupling between adjacent elements, or there is very less radiation to the adjacent elements. And by having in-phase reflection coefficient, we can have a very small profile for the antenna structures. So these are the advantages. So as said, it eliminates the drawbacks of conducting surfaces since the reflection phase is 0 degrees. So we can have a very small antenna profile. The ground plane can be placed very near to the antenna, and so the size of the antenna becomes very small. So it prevents the propagation of surface waves. So even if other materials or other structures are fabricated along with this antenna, so there won't be any waves propagating along the surface of the substrate. So the efficiency of the antenna is getting increased, and antenna gain is improved. So the back radiation or the back lobes are being reduced, and mutual coupling is also reduced. So this slide gives the applications of EBG or PBG structures. Their main application is in antennas, in noise suppression in high speed circuits or signal integrity applications. We also have it as filters or reflectors or resonant cavities. Low loss waveguides can also be created using these. So in optical region, that is when you talk about PBG, variety of applications have come up in this. So optical switches or photonic crystals, so etc., etc. it goes.